Hey everyone, this is Vince here. This video I want to talk about minding the subject of minding your own business. And what that means is it comes down to taking a look at two things. Filling out your own financial statement, and the second part is to set future financial goals. And here's the picture I have here. And this is the, if you may have seen this before, if you are familiar. And now you could draw out pictures, a bigger version of these pictures here. Or you can list them out. But what this is doing is it's showing you where you are, so you can, you know, take a look at where you are and where you want to go financially. So what you would do is you fill out your income of what you're making right now currently, and taking a look at listing all of your expenses. And if you have assets, you list those here. So you have to have your own blank sheet of paper. And then of course liabilities, and this comes down to accountability and seeing the numbers, as they say. And so, one thing that entrepreneurs do is they take a look at their account continuously, or, you know, more often than the average person. So you have you might have access to your bank. Probably these days, chances are it's true that you can monitor your own accounts online. So once you have written out everything of all your income and expenses, assets and liabilities, then you see where you are, and see now you can see where, that's another picture of where you would be headed. And now you can change that, of course, if you don't like the direction. And it comes down to the second part, which is setting financial goals. Setting up long-term goals, and in this case I've put down 5 years, and of course short-term goals over the next year, the next 12 months. So for the first year, two things to get you started is writing down how much you want to decrease in debt, if you have any debt around, and increasing your cash flow over the next 12 years per month, how much you want to increase your cash flow over the next 12 months. 12 months. Then being setting out your bigger vision is setting up for 5 years in advance. And the same thing, but here we have increasing your cash flow per month. So you put that down. Then of course you can say asset column too, or investment vehicles. But some money making opportunities might not be classified as an asset, as a true asset, but it is another way of earning an income. So I switched that to MSIs, which stands for another multiple stream of income, or multiple source of income. And you list those too as well. So those are just some things to get started. And that is what mind your own business means, as opposed to minding someone else's business if you were in a job where you're helping someone else get rich, but you can't be left behind. You have to have your own things going too. So that is what I want to share with you in this video. If you have not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe to the button around the video. And this, chances are, is still lower, you know, under the video. If you have a business and you want to take it to another level online, or if you don't have a business but you have a hobby or something that you are passionate about, so that you spend time doing outside of any work, then click the link below and you can get started by learning how to turn your passion and start making an income by doing the things that you love to do. The link is in the description box, and I will get back with you in the next video.